BXB. It's in the game.
Hey guys, it's me, Ben, back again with another one of my quick reviews as we are in E3 week right now. So I'm a little bit late with my look at Moonlighter from 11-bit Studios, who recently have come to the attention of the masses due to Frostpunk, which is this very different type of sort of strategy survival game that's on PC. However, Moonlight is much more of a traditional roguelite, but with some fun little twists. So the setup is that you are a young man, a shopkeeper, in this fantasy setting in a town that used to be full of heroes and vitality and sort of the wonders of exploration and all of this. But then there were some fatalities, there were some deaths, things didn't go well, and the town kind of degenerated into somewhat of a ghost town. Most people left. However, you, as this young shopkeeper who inherited the business, you've decided to take it in your own hands to fill the shop full of goods and wares by going into the dungeons the adventurers are now too afraid to enter and finding the items that you can then sell in your shop. So yeah, that's kind of the hook that makes this roguelike, this dungeon crawler, a little bit different. You're going to be splitting your time between two major activities. First of all, you're going to be doing the dungeon delving, the spelunking. You're going to be going down to these various themed dungeons of various difficulties with various depths up against various enemies to find various goods to sell in your shop. There's a lot of variety, some might say. You're going to go into the earlier dungeons and you're going to find types of stuff to sell in your shop. And these types of things will vary greatly. And as you collect them, you'll find out more about them. So a lot of discovery is on offer here. And the punishment for death here is a form of permadeath. When you die, though, you go right back to the start of the dungeon and you can give it another go. Now, the combat of this game, which of course is fairly integral to the experience, is one of the elements that I found slightly iffy, shall we say. Basically, you attack in the cardinal direction, so up, down, left, and right, but enemies and movement can happen in all directions, so more like an 8-pointed D-pad, as it were, but you can only attack on the 4 major directions, which makes it a bit of a pain. I found myself getting swamped and surrounded by enemies on a fairly regular basis, because they can take advantage of that kind of gap in your ability to actually attack. So that was a bit frustrating. That was one of the elements I didn't enjoy and found myself often coming sort of undone due to. One of the things I noticed in this game, because obviously it's run-based and you're going in and you're finding the goods and then selling your shop, greed really became a factor for me. I'd always want to push a little bit further than I should to try and find those items that are of the highest value, those items that I really want to sell to my customers. So let's talk about my customers. Let's talk about the shopkeeping element of this game. So there's a fairly deep management system in play here, sort of the economy. So you've got, first of all, your shop, which you will then stock with the goods you found in the dungeons. Now, you're going to be using things like the prices for the goods, and the prices for the goods will be determined by the demand of the customer and how much they think those items are worth. Price them too high, they're not going to be happy or want to buy it. Sometimes they'll actually buy it when they think it's a little bit too high, but they'll go away with sort of a status effect on them that means that they might not be as willing to come back to buy things from you in the future. So there's a lot of balancing on offer here. There's a lot of tweaking, a lot of sort of numbers and stats and thinking about what will sell well in your business. So you're going to go on trips into the dungeon, especially later on in the game, specifically targeting certain items to then turn, you know, for profit in the shop. So that's really cool and that's interesting. And in addition to that, you have this sort of town management system in play as well, which you'll be upgrading the town, bringing in other merchants, upgrading your shop, making things better. There's a lot to do here beyond just the spelunking, just beyond just delving into those dungeons and doing your roguelike business. And that's kind of the USP of this game. That's what gives this game a hook beyond the usual roguelikes that you've already played a million of. It's got a very pleasant sort of, I guess, watercolory pixel art look to it. It's got nice music, it's got nice bit of storytelling in there as well, mostly contextual, but there's some stuff at the beginning and then there's some sort of tutorialization that helps give you a framing device. But for the most part, it's contextual, finding notes and whatnot within the dungeon as you're exploring, telling you more about what to find in the subsequent dungeons and the further depths as you progress through those levels. I enjoyed my time with this. The biggest hang-up I had was the combat. The fact that there isn't a huge amount of sort of combat finesse and variety on display here. I thought there was quite a lot of variety when it came to the selling side of things, and it feels like perhaps the shopkeeper element is where the developers really latched onto this concept and really decided to explore that area a little bit deeper than the combat and the spelunking side of things. I enjoyed my time. It's certainly a lovely game to look at. It's certainly a level of polish and craft that's gone into this from 11-bit Studios, which doesn't surprise me at all, considering these are the guys behind things like Frostpunk and This War of Mine, amongst many other games. So this is a genre they maybe haven't dabbled in a huge amount in the past, so I would like to see some maybe refinement in what I'm hoping will be a sequel to this particular game. So I think, due to all of that, I'm going to give Moonlighter 3 out of 5 stars.
BXB. It's in the game!